probably everything. I mean, we toured before, you know, in situations like with Voivod and Faith No More and stuff like that, where there was actually three bands on the bill where anyone could have headlined, but it just seemed like there wasn't such a gap between the audience, you know. Everybody that paid their money could probably get something from each band on it. And when you're in a situation opening up for like a stadium tour where there's this huge gap between the audience, they don't really care who you are so much. They just kind of want to see the band whose t-shirt they have on, which is fine. It's their money, but we got to think about our fans and like playing somewhere in a situation where they want to see it and where it's for an amount of time, you know, that where they're getting their money's worth and hearing all the songs they want to hear. Yeah, for us, definitely. I mean, it's two totally different worlds. We don't try and kind of make one out of the other. You know, if a song isn't a great live song, doesn't mean it won't be a great song on a record. And some songs just play completely differently live than we do in the studio. So, you know, I don't think it helped us in terms of us being better players or anything. Nothing will save us there. No amount of practice. Yeah, well, I don't see how they could get that from it, you know. It's definitely a studio record. Maybe it's just because there's less instruments, you know, less layering of, like, tons of guitar tracks or anything. It's approached more like we've always wanted it to be, which is just everything sounds natural. Which, believe it or not, it's hard sometimes to get people to record you that way. A lot of the time, record producers and engineers, they want to record you through, you know, their boxes and their effects and whatever they think their genius is. And I think the true genius of recording a band is to record who that band is, which is also sometimes difficult to do. No. What the hell's that guy talking about?
Heavy is an interpretation. Just a single note can be very heavy if it's meant in a certain direction. I see the heaviness on both records being more similar. I don't think they're too far apart as far as the heaviness factor goes.
Well, I think that the new record is probably more diverse from a songwriting standpoint, from a vocal approach standpoint, from definitely from a sound standpoint. And I think like our last couple records probably were more guitar riff oriented and more of a premise for catharsis and being aggressive as opposed to like delivering a song or moods as well. But all of our records have been fairly diverse. Well, it created tension, and
which is sometimes necessary to get anything done.
Yeah.
He was receptive to ideas. We could bounce ideas off of him.
He was the necessary adversary.
Yeah.
He created a situation where we had someone to fight against, and then it gave us a focus for creating the record. He was someone for us to crush. He was Godzilla, and we were Mothra. You know, you can't make a record without a couple of giant super monsters fighting each other. And the record is what it sounds like when the band wins. And if the band doesn't win, it usually doesn't sound very good. I think we just allowed more diverse material to end up on the record instead of being so critical about if a song that someone wrote individually should be a Soundgarden song or not. I think we didn't think about it in those terms at all. is this a song our band would do, or is this a song it wouldn't do? We just kind of did everything, and then the ones we liked the most, we made on the record.
Yeah, it's more like songs that we can do, because we can do any of those songs, and these are the ones that we wanted.